Welcome to video series on analysis of indeterminate structures using Kani's method. In this, we are learning how to analyze continuous beams and frames using Kani's method. In this video, you will learn analysis of frame in which there are more than two members meeting at a joint using Kani's method. This is a non-sway problem because there is a support which restricts the horizontal movement of this frame. So this is a non-sway frame. We are going to analyze this using Kani's method. In this frame, you can observe here that at joint B and at joint C, there are three members meeting at joint B and C. In addition to this, there is one overhanging portion, CF. This frame is subjected to uniformly distributed load and a point load at the free end. And there is different moment of inertia for various members. Now in this frame, member EB, member AB and member CD is not subjected to any load. So in analysis of Kani's method, first step is always to calculate the fixed end moment and the joint moment. So let us start with the first step, that is calculation of fixed end moment. Now on BC, there is uniformly distributed load. So we will calculate fixed end moment for member BC. For this member EB, AB and CD, since there is no load, so fixed end moments are zero. For member BC, since it is a uniformly distributed load, so moments are minus WL square by 12 and plus WL square by 12. So we get minus 20 kilonewton meter and plus 20 kilonewton meter as fixed end moment for member BC. We know that we denote this fixed end moment by MFBC. The meaning is fixed end moment, MF means fixed end moment, B means at joint B whose far end is C. Similarly, fixed end moment at joint C whose far end is B. So this is how we designate the fixed end moment. Once you calculate fixed end moment, next is to calculate the joint moment due to this point load at F. Whenever there is an overhanging part in the frame, that part is a determinate part. That means we can calculate bending moment and shear force for this part CF considering from free end. So here at joint C, the bending moment due to 2 kilonewton is 2 into 1.5. Now remember that for joint moment, clockwise is negative and anticlockwise is positive, and therefore joint moment MCF is equal to minus 2 into 1.5. That is force into perpendicular distance is the bending moment. So joint moment is minus 3 kilonewton meter. Once you calculate fixed end moment and joint moment, next step is to calculate rotation factor. To calculate rotation factor, we use table consisting of five columns. So here joint member, K means relative stiffness, summation of relative stiffness, and rotation factor is minus half K upon summation K. So rotation factor is half times the distribution factor in moment distribution method. So here we can see here at B and C there are more than one members. So we have to calculate rotation factor at joint B and at joint C. So first let us calculate rotation factor at joint B. At joint B there are three members, BE, BA and BC. So we have to see how is the far end. So here far end is fixed, this is also fixed, and this is continuous, and therefore relative stiffness is I by L. So for all these members, relative stiffness is I by L. You substitute respective value of I and L, you will get K. Then add this to get summation K, and using this formula, we can calculate rotation factor. Once you calculate rotation factor at any joint, you must check whether the sum of this rotation factor at the joint is minus 0.5 or not. So if you add this, you will get minus 0.5. Next is to calculate rotation factor at joint C. At joint C, there are three members CB, CD, and CF. Now B is continuous end, D is fixed end. So for these two members, the relative stiffness is I by L, and CF is a cantilever part, so its relative stiffness is zero. So if you calculate this, you will get rotation factor as minus 0.3 and minus 0.2. If you add this, you will get minus 0.5. Now, since this is a non-sway problem, we don't have to calculate displacement factor. Next step is to draw the iteration table. For that, we draw two squares at the joint, that is at joint B and at joint C. So here we draw two rectangles B at B and C, and we complete this figure just similar to the frame. So for BE, this is member BE, this is member BC, CF, AB, and CD. Now on this frame, we have to write fixed end moments above these lines. So wherever there is fixed end moment, we have to write above this line. We draw small rectangles inside this rectangle, and here we write summation of fixed end moment in this small rectangle. That means sum of MFBE, MFBA, and MFBC we have to write here, and sum of MFCB, MFCE, and MFCD you have to write here. Then you have to make the diagram like this. Here towards E you have to write rotation factor for BE, towards A you have to write rotation factor for BA, and towards C you have to write rotation factor for BC. Similarly, here you have to write rotation factor for CB, CD, and here it is zero. Once you complete this, then we start the rotation contribution cycles. So first of all, we will write the fixed end moment on these members. So since there is no load on member BE, AB, and CD, these fixed end moments are zero. So we write fixed end moment like this. If there is load on column, you have to write fixed end moment at these positions. Then we write rotation factors. For member BE, towards E, we write rotation factor for BE, for BA, and BC. Similarly, here at joint C, write rotation factor for CB, CD, and here it is zero. Once you write rotation factor, then we have to start the rotation contribution. So we start with first joint, and then we calculate the values of rotation contribution for BE, BA, and BC. So we write rotation contribution for BE at this position, rotation contribution for BA at this position, in this direction, in the direction of arrow. Then for member BC, we write rotation contribution in this direction. Once you complete rotation contribution at B, go to joint C. So here we are going to write rotation contribution for CB, and here rotation contribution for CD. Now let us start the process. In this small box, we have to write sum of fixed end moment. That means sum of this value minus 20, 0, and 0, which is minus 20. Here again, sum of fixed end moment at joint C, that is 20 plus 0 minus 3 is 17. Now we will start the rotation contribution cycles. So first we will calculate values at joint B. For joint B, what are the far ends? Far ends are E, C, and A. So initially we don't have any values. So we will write 0 here, 0 here, and 0 here. So what are the rotation contribution values here? it is 0 plus 0 plus 0, that is far end values, plus sum of fixed end moment multiplied by rotation factor, right here for BE, right here for BA, and right here for BC. So we will get these values, that is 6.4, 1.2, and 2.4. How do we get this 6.4? It is addition of far end values, that is 0, 0, 0, plus fixed end moment multiplied by minus 0.32 is 6.4. Then minus 0.06 is 1.2, and minus 0.012 is 2.4. Once you calculate the values at B, go to joint C. At joint C, here we have value 0. So first of all, draw a line like this and then calculate the rotation contribution values at joint C. How we get these values? For this, there are far end values, which is 2.4 and 0. Far end values plus sum of fixed end moment, that is 17. So 2.4 plus 0 plus 17, whatever you get, that is 19.4, multiply by minus 0.3 right here, multiply by minus 0.2 right here. So this completes first cycle. Similarly, we calculate values in other cycle. Again, go to joint B, cut the initial values and calculate the fresh values. Now for calculating fresh value at joint B, we have the values 0, 0, and this value, CB value, that is minus 5.82. If you add this 0 plus 0 minus 5.82 minus 20 to this, multiply by this right here, multiply by this right here, and multiply by this right here. So let us calculate it. So first cut the initial values, the old values, and then you write the new values. How we get this 8.26? It is 0 plus 0 minus 5.82 minus 20 multiply by minus 0.32 right here, minus 0.06 right here, and multiply by minus 0.12 right here. So this is rotation contribution at joint B in second cycle. Similarly, go to joint C and calculate rotation contribution at joint C. For this, first you draw a line on these old values. So cut the old values. Now new value will be addition of 3.1 plus 0 plus 17 multiply by minus 0.3 right here, multiply by minus 0.2 right here. So we will get new values. This completes second cycle. Similarly, we calculate the values in third cycle. So go to joint B and then calculate again the new values in same way. Go to joint C, calculate new values in same way. Then you will observe that the values in next step are similar to the previous values. Once you get similar values, you stop the iteration. So these values, which are marked by green color, these are the final values of rotation contribution. Once you get final values of rotation contribution at each joint, then next step is to calculate final moments. To calculate the final moment, we have this formula. That is, final moment is equal to 2 times rotation contribution at near end plus rotation contribution at far end plus displacement contribution plus fixed end moment. Now, since this is a non-sway problem, there will not be any displacement contribution. So final moment will be 2 times rotation contribution at near end plus rotation contribution at far end plus fixed end moment. So let us see how to calculate it. Let us calculate first the final moment for member EB. For member EB at joint E, that is MEB, near value is 0, far value is 8.33. So 2 times 0 plus 8.33 plus fixed end moment is the final moment MEB. then MBE is 2 times 8.33 plus 0 plus 0. We get 16.66 as MBE. So this is how we calculate the final moments. Now let us calculate final moment for BA. Now what will be the value for BA? So here 2 times 1.56 plus 0. Fixed end moment is 0 here. So we get 3.12. Now how we get value here? It is 2 times 0 plus 1.56. So we get 1.56. Then we calculate for BC. For BC, 2 times 3.12 minus 6.03 minus 20, we get 19.79. Now here MCB is 2 times minus 6.03 plus 3.12 plus 20 is 11.06. Similarly, we calculate final moment for CD. So for CD, 2 times near value plus far value, that is 2 times minus 4.02 plus 0, fixed end moment is 0 in this case, so final value is minus 8.04. Here 2 times 0 minus 4.02 and fixed end moment is 0, therefore final value MDC is equal to minus 4.02. This we can write in equation form also. Either you can solve like this or using equations. So this is the given problem and we can calculate final end moment using this formula. So let us consider first member EB. For this, we know that 2 times rotation contribution at near end plus far end plus fixed end moment, we get this value. For BE, 2 times rotation contribution at near end plus far end plus fixed end moment, we get this value. So similarly, we can calculate for member BC, 2 times rotation contribution at near end plus far end plus fixed end moment, we get the final value. So this is how we calculate for member BC. Similarly, we can calculate for column BA and member BA and AB. Similarly, we calculate for column CD. So these are the final end values. And we know that for member CF, we have already calculated, it is minus 3 kilonewton meter. Once you calculate all the values of final moment, the last step is to draw the bending moment diagram. Now let us see how the bending moment diagram will look like in this case. So here, the bending moment diagram will be something like this. To draw this bending moment diagram, first of all, you have to draw the outline of this frame. Then first you draw the ordinate for member EB like this, then join these members, these ordinates, then you draw ordinates for member BA, join this, then draw ordinate for members CD and then join this, then you draw ordinates for beam and join this. After this, this is the net diagram. So the ordinates or the figure which is above the line is the negative diagram and below the line is the positive diagram. Similarly, which is inside the frame is positive and outside the frame is negative. So here this is positive. This is positive bending moment diagram, which is also called as free bending moment diagram. This is due to this UDL, that is WL square by 8. So if you calculate it, you will get 30. 30 is this complete ordinate. This is minus. So inside the frame is plus and outside the frame is minus. Similarly, here it is minus, here it is plus. Here it is minus, this is minus, and this is also negative and this is positive. So this is how we can draw the bending moment diagram in this case. I hope you will find this video useful to understand how to analyze a portal frame which is non-sway frame. So stay connected to understand structural analysis and design problems in a simplified way. Thank you for watching this video.